Now, I don't know if you enjoy a good crossword puzzle at all. Well, if you do, you may be interested to know that it was on this day, the 21st of December in 1913, that the very first puzzle appeared in a New York newspaper. And here it is. Obviously, it looks quite different to the usual black and white squares that we associate with the crossword puzzles of today. And there was no across or down clues, just numbered questions. The editor of the New York World newspaper, a man named Arthur Wynn, is often credited as the creator of the crossword. But some historians point out that similar word games can actually be traced as far back as Pompeii. Now, I like to attempt a crossword puzzle every now and then, and it's always great when you get off to a fast start and you know the first few clues and you can fill in the acrosses and the downs. But then there are other times when I'm just left staring blankly at the page and I literally haven't got a clue. You know, life can be a bit like this at times, because we're not given all the answers to the puzzle that can be our life. We maybe are given clues and pointers along the way, but it's up to us to find the answers for ourselves. But there is someone who can help. The Bible says, "Don't you know? Haven't you been listening? He is the one and only everlasting God, the creator of all that you can see and imagine. He never gets weary or worn out. His intelligence is unlimited. He is never puzzled over what to do." As a Christian, I choose to put my trust in God, who is the creator of everything that I can see and imagine. And so when I'm faced with a puzzle that I'm trying to solve, I turn to Him, because I know that He has all the answers.